brave soldiers protect the historical city of Prague. But from who? What enemy crosses their path, and how do they defend their territory? Rumor says there could be some skate monsters overtaking the city. Let's see who's coming. Indeed, it's the Mystic Skate Cup monster flying in, and everybody is eager to follow the call of the monsters to Prague because it's the Mystic Skate Cup which returns again, this time with the Street Skate semifinals. Let's see what kind of inspiration this park can build.
Right here we have a world-class course for skateboarding. You see all the variety of the ledges and handrails and grass caps and banks and everything. So much variety of a skate park. This is a world-class course. It has a great flow. And when you have a great course like this with the best skaters, it's going to be a great show.
I love these street cars. It's so fun to skate there. I always have fun with my friends.
It's the best one. The best one. I love it.
Too hard for me. Too big.
The street car is kind of big. All the obstacles are very big. But it's a fun park.
Course is always great at Mystic. Course is feeling good. My wrist is super messed up, so kind of dealing with that. But other than that, everything's good.
Whoever doesn't wear themselves out in practice, that's the key. A lot of these guys get so amped, they like skate in practice and they just kind of get worn out, but I don't know. It's gonna be close, it's gonna be a good contest.
And here he comes, last year's Mystic Skate Cup winner, Austin Seaholm, ready to rock. Most FDD, 30 skaters waiting in the wings for the semifinal. And it's a local guy, Maxim Habenich, also a Mystic winner, who opens up the course. Let the heats begin. Five riders will show off their best in six heats, and we will show you the street highlights. Nice 360 from Benny Garcia. Clearly, these skaters are really trying to use every piece of the course here. Great show for his homies by the tallest of the crew, Lucas Danik from Prague. Dropping sake bombs on course is the well-known Japanese styler Ryo Sajiri. He is a tech freak and strings together the most difficult lines. It's insane. The huge crowd here is loving it. Nice backside lip slide by the lanky Maxime Genin. The little skate wonder kid Aurelien, who likes to fly extremely high. Remember this talented Kim from the Bowl competition? Well, he's rocking the street now. Bolarola Brulio from the Smith stall up on the quarter pipe back into the rail. Amazing. And then he launches into a stale 360. Booyah! All right, looking at last year's third place ripper, Thomas Steiskel. He knows this course by heart and also likes to take some risks. Rider Danny Leon again with a big kickflip over the hydrant obstacle. He's not too shabby in the street either. What's that? Oops, that's gonna hurt Danny. All right, this is the number one European qualifier, Austria's Patrick Pittel, with perfect performances on this course. But never count out the local Martin Peck. Ollie clicking on the course. And Aussie Chad Barty still ripping as hard as ever at 36 years young. Whoa. In the next heat, the nicest line's definitely going to style master Axel Kruisbergs from Belgium, including the crunch slide. Czech Force Thomas Vinter has to risk the stairs for a chance at the finals. Nice one. Last heat coming up, and it's the first go for American boy Austin Siouxhomme, who rode directly into the semis with a nose manual and a big launch. His backside 180 looks like Siouxhomme is going to do it. But Brazilian whiz kid Diego Fiorezzi will try to steal the show. Switch frontside 270. Ouch! Gonna go for it again though. Austin going ballistic, but Diego answers with an ollie back heel. And from another planet, a 3-meter high Benihana. Oh my god! Finals on the next Rebel TV.